There is none to take your place.
Hallelujah.
There is none to stand before you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Worthy are you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Worthy to be thanks and praise.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord. A pleasant
Thank you,
good evening
Jesus.
to all those that I have
Praise the
logged in
Lord.
this evening, whether you're on Facebook Live or whether you're on Zoom tonight. Praise the name of the Lord. This evening is indeed, my God, a special evening. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise
It
the
is
Lord.
the Feast of Trumpets. My God, happy Rosh Hashanah, my God, to all my Christian brethren this evening. Praise the name of the Lord, my
Praise the
God,
Lord.
that is observing, my God, another time of rehearsal. Praise the name of the Lord. We are the New Creation Ministries, and we are coming to you live this evening with, my God, our Feast of Trumpets service. Praise the name of the Lord. My God, I'm your host this evening, Reverend Michelle Santros, and with me, no stranger than a custom leading the charge, my God, is our very own Bishop Carl Santros. This evening, it's an honor, it's a privilege, my God, to come to you, my God, wheresoever you might be located at this evening, whether
Oh,
you're in
thank
your
you, Jesus.
homes, whether you're in your job places, whether
Hallelujah.
you're in your cars, praise
Yes,
the name
Lord.
of the Lord, whether you're situated in your porch, my God,
Praise the
wheresoever
Lord.
you might be at, my God, it's an honor, it's a privilege, my God, to be able to come, my God, within this special service, my God, God's divine appointment, another time of rehearsal. We are celebrating, we are observing the Feast of Trumpets. Praise the name of the Lord. This evening, my God, we would like to open in a word of prayer. But my God, as we were accustomed doing, because my God, it's a biblical practice, my God, we would sound the shofar. And
Praise the
sounding
Lord.
the shofar, my
Thank you,
God, it
Jesus.
break down walls, and because it represents the voice of God. Praise the
Amen,
name of
amen,
the Lord.
amen.
My God, when the shofar is being sung, my God, everything that is out of the divine alignment this evening with the will and purpose of God, it comes back into divine
Oh,
alignment, and
hallelujah.
His will and His purpose, my God, once the person surrenders.
My
Praise the
God,
name of
amen,
the Lord.
amen.
Praise the name of Jesus. So this evening, my God, we would like to sound the shofar. And whilst the shofar is being sounded tonight, praise the name of the Lord, I will open in prayer.
Oh,
Praise the name of
hallelujah.
the Lord.
Father, we
Hallelujah.
give you praise.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. We bless your holy
Father,
name. Who is like unto our
yes,
God
Lord,
this
yes,
evening?
Lord,
There
yes,
is
Lord.
none like unto him. We worship you, O God,
oh,
in the beauty of your holiness.
Father,
Father, we
praise.
thank you this evening, O
Thank
Father,
you, Lord.
for your
Thank
tender
you, Lord.
grace and your tender
Thank you.
mercies. We thank you for your faithfulness,
Oh,
O God.
hallelujah.
We thank you for your loving kindness, His power.
Kindness.
Father, this evening, in the mighty name of Jesus, as your ecclesia have gathered together, O God, we have gathered together, O Father, to recognize another appointment, mighty Father, your divine appointment with us this evening, another time of rehearsal, O God, right now in the name of Jesus, we bring everything, O Father, including ourselves under the anointing, and under the obedience, and under the authority of your spoken words, in the name of Jesus, we take authority over the very atmosphere, O God, and we bind principalities and powers, we bind rulers of darkness and spiritual wickedness in high places tonight, in the name of Jesus, as the shofar sounds out tonight, O God, everything that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, we bind their works and cancel their assignments, we uproot, O God, their purpose in our homes, in our lives, O God, and we cast them out, in the name of Jesus, we decree and declare, O God, that the anointing of your Holy Ghost, we will take preeminence this
yes,
hour,
Lord, yes, Lord.
But it's not by might, it
not
is by power, but it's by your spirit,
by your spirit.
As we humble ourselves,
oh,
O God, under your mighty hand of grace, show up, O God, and show up yourself, Father, be glorified,
be glorified
in the midst of us, be magnified, O God, as we exalt your matchless name, we worship you tonight, O God, we bless your holy name, we give you glory in this house tonight. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Father, we
praise
give you
the
praise.
Name of the Lord.
We give you
Thank
honor.
You, Lord.
We give you
Thank
glory.
You, Jesus.
We bless your
Hallelujah.
Name. Hallelujah.
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 We thank you, Lord.
Yeah,
We
Lord.
thank
Yeah,
you,
Lord.
Jesus. We thank you for your tender grace. We thank you for your tender mercies. We thank you for your love and kindness. You are worthy, O God. Worthy to be praised. Worthy to be thanked. And worthy to be worshipped and adored tonight. Oh, we exalt you tonight, O God. We exalt you tonight, O God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the name of the living God.
We bless your holy name.
Thank you, Jesus.
We
bless your name tonight.
Hallelujah.
Tonight, believers, my God, we want to encourage you to share the life. My God, if you're on Facebook Live, you can share the live. Praise the name of the Lord. And if you're on Zoom tonight, which the majority always is, my God, you can share the link tonight.
Praise the name of the Lord.
My God, another Feast of Trumpets where we are reminded tonight, my God, that Jesus Christ, my God, our bridegroom tonight, he's coming back for his bride, the church. Praise the name of the Lord. It's another time of rehearsal. Praise the name of the Lord. And oh, what a season it is tonight. Amen.
My God,
it begins, my God, because right after Feast of Trumpets, we have Atonement and Tabernacles.
Yes,
praise
Lord.
The name of the Lord. So tonight, believers, we would like to usher into praise and worship. Praise the name of the Lord. I want to encourage you, gather your family. It's a time. It's a God's divine appointment with us tonight.
Amen. My God,
let us, my God, worship tonight. Let us have fellowship tonight.
Father,
praise the name
price.
Of the Lord. And
price.
I guarantee you tonight that you will, your life will never
hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Oh,
tonight,
hallelujah.
My God, it gives me great honor.
Yes, Lord.
And great privilege, my God, to
hallelujah.
Give to us all who would lead us, my God, in worship this evening, our very own Sister Siobhan, Sister Genevieve, and Sister Kylie Sandrose.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank
hallelujah.
You. Yes, Lord.
Thank
hallelujah.
You, Jesus.
Father,
like hallelujah.
Praise
take your place.
Praise the
Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Worthy to be magnified.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
We worship
thank
you,
Lord.
Yeah.
running after. It's running after me.
With my life
and now, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after. It's running after. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am in,
yes, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
And all my life you have been so,
so
good. With every breath that I am
in, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We praise you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Glory. Hallelujah. Yes,
Lord.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Oh,
Hallelujah. Lord. The dead Christ shall rise. Hallelujah. Woo.
The dead in Christ shall rise.
At the midnight cry, when Jesus comes again.
When Jesus comes again.
Oh, Ramabasapapa. And then those that remain. They will be quickly changed. Hallelujah.
They will be quickly changed.
Oh, at the midnight cry. Hallelujah.
And at the midnight cry.
Jesus comes again.
When Jesus comes again.
Oh, 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 Satan, am I here? Oh, at the midnight cry. Hallelujah.
And at the midnight cry.
When Jesus comes again.
When Jesus comes again.
When Jesus comes again.
When Jesus comes again.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Father, we give you the praise.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, we give you the honor.
Praise the name of the Lord.
We give you the glory.
Hallelujah.
We bless your holy name.
Hallelujah.
We lift up your name.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Yeah, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Have that midnight cry.
Hallelujah.
At that midnight cry.
Thank you, Lord.
When Jesus comes again.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Praise
Believers,
the Lord.
Praise the name of the Lord, my God. This evening, my God, it's another year. Today marks another day. Praise the name of the Lord. In the year, according to God's calendar, my God, it is the Feast of Trumpets. Praise the name of the Lord. What does this mean, my God, for the child of God, my God, for the believers this evening, my God? It means that it's another time of rehearsal. Praise the name of the Lord. My God, this evening we thank God, my God, for his sovereign grace. We thank God for his mercies tonight. Praise the name of the Lord. My God, when we reflect, my God, on the plans of God, my God, he fulfilled Passover. He fulfilled first fruits. He fulfilled Pentecost, and next on the list to be fulfilled, it is the Feast of Trumpets, my God, which refers to the rapture or the taking away of the church this evening. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Believers, my God, this evening, my God, it starts, my God, another powerful season, my God, of the move of God more than ever. Praise the name of the Lord. My God, it's a powerful season for divine miracles and breakthroughs. Praise the name of the Lord. My God, there are already testimonies that are coming in, my God. Just this evening, one person was sharing with me, my God, they were looking, my God, at the three nights of deeper life, my God, and they were reflecting more or less on a need that the family had. Praise the name of the Lord. And my God, the very next day, they got a phone call, my God, establishing and showing, my God, that God was on the move. God knew their heart. He knew their need. Praise the name of the Lord. And he has promised us tonight to meet us at the point of our needs.
Praise
tonight.
The
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
He's our needs supplier tonight.
Amen.
Amen.
He is.
So my God, believers, praise the name of the Lord. It's a powerful season.
Oh,
when
hallelujah.
We look throughout the Bible, the Old Testament, my God, and the New Testament, you will realize that around the Feast of the Lord, my God, it was time, my God, like it was a time for divine miracles like never before.
My God,
praise
my God.
The name of the Lord. My God, people experience, my God, the very hand of God. It speaks or it reflects his power. Praise the name of the Lord. But we have to, my God, ensure that we align ourselves, my God, in
Praise
the correct
Lord.
Position to receive from him tonight. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Tonight,
Amen.
Believers, my God, it gives me great honor this evening to be able, my God, to even, my God, be celebrating yet another birthday of mine's, my God, on today. Praise the name of the
Praise
Lord.
The Lord.
Feast of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. My God, I give God praise and thanks for life. I thank God for his mercies. Praise the name of the Lord, his love and kindness. I thank God for blessing me, my God, with the best family in the whole wide world. Praise the name of the Lord. I thank God, my God, for my loving husband, my children. Praise the name of the Lord, my sons-in-laws. Praise the name of the Lord, my grandson. Praise the name of the Lord. I thank God for each and every one of them. I thank God for my friends and my families, my brethren this evening. Praise the name of the Lord. I thank God, my God, for each and every one of you. My God, I thank God for the love, the outpouring of love. My God, you have not ceased, my God, on all of social media this evening, today, I should say, whether on WhatsApp, Messenger. My God, for those of you who place my picture up as in your status for the day. My God, for those of you who are Instagram and Facebook. My God, I saw each and every one of your greetings. Praise the name of the Lord. My God, and thank you. Praise the name of the Lord for your outpouring of love and your encouragement this evening. My God, may the grace of God, my God, and his blessings continue to cover and abide, my God, you and your families. Praise the name of the Lord, as long as the Lord should tarry this evening. Amen. Thank God for all the phone calls as well. Praise the name of the Lord. We love you this evening. Praise the name of the Lord. So this evening, believers, my God, I'm excited. My God, we came out of Three Nights Deeper Life Service, and a lot is has been testifying concerning those three nights and how much, my God, they received and how much, my God, it refreshed and revived them. Praise the name of the Lord, my God. And we want to continue on that same trend tonight. Praise the name of the Lord, because, my God, Feast of Trumpets have already kicked off. It has begun. My God, I should say, my God, that which leads to atonement and tabernacles. Praise the name of the Lord. So we want to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to his children this evening. My God, to break the bread of life to us all this evening. My God, no stranger, my God, to you and I is our very own. And I thank God for this man of God. I thank God for his availability. My God, it's not easy. My God, the sacrifices. My God, the wee hours of the night, the wee hours of the morning. My God, he's up, he's tarrying, he's laboring. My God, whether it be in the word or whether it be, my God, in prayer and in counsel. My God, he is forever laboring on behalf of God's kingdom. And God is going to bless. He's going to continue to increase because, my God, when we look at the faithful steward, my God, we would realize, my God, for those that, my God, invested in their abilities, my God, wisely, and they brought back interest, the Lord multiplied unto them. Amen. And I know that God is going to continue, my God, to broaden his horizons. My God, there's no limitation, Bishop, my God, as to them, my God, that will give, my God, faithful service, my God, in the kingdom of God. My God, your reward, it is sure this evening. Amen. Amen. So, my God, believers, it's another time of visitation. Let's hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to his people this evening. Praise to the break Lord. The bread of life for us all is our very own Bishop and Reverend Carl Centros.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Pastor Michelle. The birthday girl, praise the name of the Lord. We really give God praise and thanks for the span of a life to see another year. And we know that God is abundantly able to continue to bless her with many, many more years. Amen. I thank God. I have much to give God praise for because she is my gift that is given to me from God. Praise the Lord. Amen. And I really thank God for her in a special way. Praise the name of the Lord. You know, today, hallelujah, it's another wonderful privilege, you know, that we can come together and rejoice and celebrate such a day. And this day, it marked the feast or the day of the Feast of Trumpet. It marked, you know, Rosh Hashanah. Praise the name of the Lord. A day that is appointed by God to reflect and remember what is God's plan or one of God's plan for the future. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. And that plan of God for the future, praise the name of the Lord, it is the promise that the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ made. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. And if it was not so, I would have told you. Yes. But I'm going to prepare a place for you. I'm going to come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Praise the Lord. Amen. And my God, hallelujah. I want you to understand that we know and we are confident that all the promises of God, they are here and they are amen. God will not go back on his promises. Amen. Amen. And yes, my God, we have been waiting, praise the name of the Lord, for that promise. Over 2,000 years, the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ left this earth. And we are waiting, praise the name of the Lord, for that promise. For when he will come in the air, praise the name of the Lord, and we will be caught up, hallelujah, and the dead in Christ will be risen to meet him, and we will be caught up to meet them in the air, and we shall go and live forever with the Lord, praise the name of the Lord. My God, yes, we are excited about that time. Amen. But I want you to know that this is a time of rehearsal. It is a time of getting ready and making sure that we are ready to meet him, praise the Lord. We had those nights of deeper life, powerful nights of deeper life, and there is nothing more powerful than the word of God. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. You know, Paul said, you know, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation. When we talk about power, talk about the word. Praise the name of the Lord. Yes. When you are able, hallelujah, to come together and dissect and rightly divide the word of God and understand the word of God, you are understanding power. Praise the name of the Lord. Yes. I want you to know, my God, the Bible teaches that they that know their God shall be strong. They who know him shall be strong and do great exploit. And my God, we can only know him through his word. Jesus said, in the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. I want you to understand, praise the name of the Lord, hallelujah. The more you know the word, it is the more you get to know the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. So my God, today as we celebrate, praise the name of the Lord, Rosh Hashanah, praise the name of the Lord, as we celebrate this wonderful festival, my God, which mark also the beginning of the Sibyl New Year for Israel, praise the name of the Lord. The Sibyl New Year for Israel, it began, hallelujah, it began on this day, praise the name of the Lord. And I want you to understand, praise the name of the Lord, hallelujah, my God, it is an appointment, it is a date that is set by God, praise the name of the Lord. Amen. And God wants us at all time, hallelujah, my God, to remember what is the true purpose of this time. The true purpose of this time, it is to always remember, hallelujah, that Jesus is coming back for us. It is to always remember, hallelujah, that the kingdom of this world shall become the kingdom of our God. And what we are seeing right now, praise the name of the Lord, is a transition that is taking place. And that transition that is taking place, it is taking place from one kingdom to another kingdom. Praise the name of the Lord. Yes. And my God and Jesus, hallelujah, is about, praise the name of the Lord, hallelujah, to come and totally, my God, crush the systems of this world. My God, we are already crushing our system. Amen. Yes. But Jesus, hallelujah, is about to come and totally take over the system of this world. Renovate, my God, what we can see here. Praise the name of the Lord. And usher in, my God, a new system. My God, a system, hallelujah, of fairness. A system of righteousness, a system, hallelujah, of complete and total happiness. Praise the name of the Lord. As it was in the beginning, so shall it be in the end. Praise the name of the Lord. And my God, as we talk about in the end, we are talking about, hallelujah, when the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, praise the name of the Lord, hallelujah, will transform or completely or totally, my God, renovate or transform this place, hallelujah. And my God, and we will be able to live as it was when God originally created, hallelujah, my God, the earth. And I want you to understand God's original creation was perfect, hallelujah. It was perfect. Even the recreation, hallelujah, was perfect. The Bible said, when God looked at what he created, hallelujah, The Bible said it was good. Everything was good. Praise the name of the Lord. But we know that sin, hallelujah, have contaminated. My God, sin has contaminated our world. And because of one man's sin, sin have passed upon all men. Because of one man's sin, sin has passed upon all men. But somebody, hallelujah, because of God's love for us, because, hallelujah, of God's love for mankind, God never stopped loving us. The Bible teaches, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whomsoever will believe in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. So God sent his son, my God, to redeem us. He sent his son, hallelujah, to deliver us, my God, from this sick, sinned world, hallelujah. And somebody, as much as receive him now, to them he gave the power to become the sons of God. The sons of God, hallelujah, so that we can be marked, hallelujah. The Bible teaches we are sealed until the day of redemption, hallelujah. Yes. We are sealed until the day of redemption. What does that mean? It means God has marked us, hallelujah. We are God's royal priesthood. We are God's chosen generation, hallelujah. And I want you to understand, he's coming back for us. He's coming back for us, but he wants us to be ready. You see, praise the name of the Lord, the time that we are celebrating, hallelujah, my God, Rosh Hashanah, praise the name of the Lord, during the time of Rosh Hashanah, hallelujah, and my God, and also the 10 days of repentance, people, what used to happen, it is people can repent of their sins and do good deeds to increase their chances of being inscribed in the book of life. So what, my God, one of the practices during Rosh Hashanah, it is people, my God, do good deeds, and to do good deeds with intention, my God, with the hope, my God, hallelujah. People also repent of their sin and they do good deeds, because I want you to understand, my God, if you don't repent of your sins, all your good deeds become null and void. Praise the name of the Lord. So, my God, repentance of sin is necessary for your good deeds to be effective. Amen. So what used to happen, or what happens even now, praise the name of the Lord, people repent their sin and they do good deeds to increase their chances of being inscribed in the book of life. Now, during Rosh Hashanah, at the synagogue services, what used to happen, my God, it is the ram horn will be blown, hallelujah, at 100 times less one. 100 times less one. And that less one there, it is being left for the blowing of that last trump, hallelujah, which is being called the trump of God, hallelujah. When that trump is being sung, that last trump, then the dead in Christ is going to rise first. And they that are alive and remain shall be caught up together in the air with them to meet the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. My God, I want you to understand that Rosh Hashanah, hallelujah, or Rosh Hashanah is sometimes referred to as the day of judgment.
Yes.
It is referred to as the day of judgment. Praise the name of the Lord. You see, Jesus said that he has the authority to judge people. Praise the name of the Lord. And my God, and the Apostle Paul, he referred to him as the judge and the judge, hallelujah, of the living and the dead. Hallelujah. You see, my God, if you look at me in St. John Gospel, chapter 5, verses 24 to 27, that is St. John Gospel, chapter 5, verses 24 to 27. Praise the name of the Lord. Jesus is speaking here. Jesus said, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believeth on him that sent me had everlasting life. And he shall not come unto condemnation, but is passed from death unto life." Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. verses 25. He said, verily, verily, I say unto you, the hour is coming. The hour is coming and now is. Praise the name of the Lord. The hour is coming and now is when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and they that hear it shall live. Praise the name of the Lord. They shall live. They shall hear the voice of the Son of God. The dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God. You see, my God, this is the reason why Jesus said, and now is. So he was not speaking, hallelujah, of the dead that were in the grave. He was talking about those who are spiritually dead. He was talking about those who are spiritually dead. But Jesus was saying then that now is, hallelujah, the hour that the dead, hallelujah, the dead, my God, shall hear the voice of the dead, shall hear the voice of the Son of God. And they that hear the voice, they that listen, come on somebody, they that pay attention, hallelujah, to the voice of God shall live. You see, praise the name of the Lord. You know, my God, when you read that scripture, hallelujah, praise the name of the Lord, you will see, my God, Jesus is speaking here about the spiritually dead. One can be alive in the flesh, but spiritually dead, hallelujah.
Yes.
But I want you to understand, even in the time of Rosh Hashanah, it is a time to hear the voice of the Son of God. I want you to understand, when you hear the voice of the preacher, when you hear the voice, hallelujah, of my God, of the man or the woman of God, you're hearing the voice of the Son of God. And my God, Rosh Hashanah is a time, if you are dead in your spirit, it is a time to come alive.
Yes.
If you're spiritually dead, it is a time to come alive. You know, Jesus at one time in Matthew chapter 8 and verses 22, Jesus, hallelujah, said unto an individual there, that is Matthew chapter 8 and verses 22, the Bible reads it, but Jesus said unto him, follow me and let the dead bury the dead. Follow me and let the dead bury the dead.
Yeah.
Somebody, how can the dead bury the dead?
Yeah.
How can one come out of the grave,
yeah,
and take one who, yeah, is physically dead,
yeah,
and place them in the grave?
Yeah.
That is not what Jesus was speaking of.
Yeah.
Jesus was talking about,
yeah,
those who are dead,
yeah,
those who don't know him,
yeah,
those who are not living for God,
yeah,
those who, hallelujah, are not saved.
Yeah.
He was saying, my God, you follow me,
yeah,
follow me, and make sure that your life is in me, hallelujah,
yeah,
but let those who are dead, spiritually dead,
yeah,
let them bury the dead, hallelujah,
yeah.
I want you to understand,
yeah,
praise the name of the Lord,
yeah,
there are those, hallelujah,
yeah,
who are walking and living,
yeah,
my God, in the flesh,
yeah,
and I want you to understand, yes,
yeah,
my God, they are breathing,
yeah,
the breath, my God, they are breathing the breath of life through their mouth and through their nostril, but my God, they are spiritually dead. But somebody, hallelujah, Rosh Hashanah, it is a time to come alive. It is a time to come alive. If you look, hallelujah, and also, my God, Ephesians chapter 2, verses 1, hallelujah, to 9, you'll see Paul said there, and he had quickened who were dead in your trespasses and sins, wherein in time past you walk according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of the disobedient.
Yeah.
My God, I want you to understand,
yeah,
if you're walking and living in the flesh,
yeah,
if you're walking and living in sin,
yeah,
my God, you are, my God, you are spiritually dead,
yeah,
even while you are alive in the flesh, hallelujah,
yeah.
Oh yes, hallelujah,
yeah.
Verses 3,
yeah,
Paul said, among whom also,
yeah,
we all had our conversation,
yeah,
in time past,
yeah,
in the lust of our flesh,
yeah,
fulfilling the desires of our flesh,
yeah,
and of our mind and were by nature the children of wrath. We were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. Children of wrath, it meaning we were by nature those who the wrath of God will come upon. We were the children of wrath. We were destined. We were born, my God, to experience or to feel the wrath of God. If we did not give Jesus our life, if we did not commit ourselves to the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Why? Because we were the children of wrath, even as others. Hallelujah. So somebody, Rosh Hashanah, it is a time, my God, to be not children of the wrath of God, but children of life. Hallelujah. It is a time to know whether the wrath of God is the mark that is upon you, or the life of God is the mark that is upon you. I want you to understand it is a time of introspection. It is a time of repentance. It is a time of rehearsal. Verses 4. My God, Paul went on to say in verses 4, he said, but God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love, wherewith he loved us. For his great love, wherewith he loved us. Hallelujah. Even when we were dead in our sins. When we were dead in our sins. And when I say sins, sins or sin is transgression against the laws of God. If you're transgressing the laws of God, I want you to understand, man, woman, you are in sin. And the wrath of God is upon you. My God. You are marked with the wrath of God unless you repent and unless, my God, you serve Jesus Christ the way you ought to serve him. Then I want you to know the wrath of God is upon you. Yeah. Paul said, even when we were dead, we at one time were dead in sins. How did he quicken? Oh, quicken there mean to make alive. Quicken us together with Christ. By grace I was saved. By grace I was saved. And had risen us up together and made us to be seated or to sit together where? In heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. I want you to understand your conversation must be in heaven.
Yes.
Your seat must be in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. Your life, hallelujah, must be, hallelujah, in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. My God, hallelujah. Verses 7. Praise the name of the Lord. My God. Verse 7, Paul said that in the ages to come, he might show the exceeding riches of his grace and his kindness towards us through Jesus Christ. For by grace I was saved through faith, and that not of yourself, it is the gift of God. Not of works, lest any man should boast. I want you to understand, listen to me, somebody. It is my God. It is faith working together with works. Hallelujah. Good works that bring about justification. Somebody, I want you to understand. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, my God. There are those who are spiritually dead. And in my God, Rosh Hashanah, it is a time for you to see, my God, if you are alive in Christ or if you are dead and the wrath of God is upon you, and my God, and shake yourself up, repent, and my God, and let the grace of God be upon you. Oh yes, my God. You know, Paul in 1 Timothy chapter 5 and verses 6, 1 Timothy chapter 5 and verses 6, Paul said, but she that liveth in pleasure. Paul said in 1 Timothy chapter 5 and verses 6, but she that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth. 1 Timothy chapter 5 and verses 6, but she that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth. I want you to understand, listen to me, somebody. My God, Paul is talking about pleasure. My God, it means to live righteously. I'm not righteously, but righteously. My God, it means, my God, to live, my God, wantonly. It means to live wantonly. It means mean to live carelessly. It mean, my God, to live, my God, anyhow. And not, my God, how God will have you to live. I want you to understand, Paul said, but she that liveth in pleasure is dead even while she liveth. Hallelujah. Oh, somebody, I said to you, hallelujah, I said to you that, my God, hallelujah, Jesus said he has the authority to judge his people. And the apostle Paul also referred, hallelujah, to him as the judge of the living and the dead, as the judge of the living and the dead. Hallelujah. You see, if you look at me in 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verses 1, 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verses 1. Hallelujah. Paul said in 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verses 1. He said, I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ. I charge thee before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead. Who shall judge the quick, the quick, or those who are alive and those who are dead, and his appearing and his kingdom. I want you to understand, my God, in the time of Rosh Hashanah, as I told you, it is also called the day of judgment. And somebody, the Bible teaches that judgment begins first at the house of God. And if judgment begins at the house of God, where shall the sinners, where shall the ungodlies appear? If judgment begins with us, where shall sinners and where shall the ungodly appear? I want you to understand, listen to me, somebody. Any forgiveness for sinners, it is now if they repent. My God, if they die in their sin, they will go to hell. I want you to understand, my God, where shall the ungodly appear? Any, my God, forgiveness for the ungodly is if he turn around and he become godly now. Hallelujah. I want you to understand, if he die, my God, not being godly, then he will die in his sin. He will perish. He will be condemned. Hallelujah. Somebody, Rosh Hashanah, it is a time of introspection. It is a time of, my God, of rehearsal, getting your spirit in sure that you are ready to meet the Lord. You see, God, hallelujah, does have a book of life. And that is what the children of Israel have been looking forward or celebrating all those years. My God, for the name to be inscribed in the Lamb's book of life. I said God had a book of life, and it is called, he calls it the Lamb book of life. God had a book of life, and he calls it the Lamb book of life. Those, my God, who are listed in that book, it is those who are saved. Those who are listed in that book, it is those who are spiritually alive and not spiritually dead. And my God, if you look at Revelation chapter 21 and verses 27. Praise the name of the Lord. Revelations 21 and verses 27. The Bible reads there, hallelujah. And there shall in no wise. And I want you to listen to this. And there shall in no wise enter into it anything that is defiled. Neither whatsoever work it abomination or make it a lie, but they which are written in the Lamb's book of life. They which are written in the Lamb's book of life. And let us come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Oh yes, hallelujah. I want you to read that again with me. And there shall in no wise enter into it, that is into the kingdom of God, that is into that place that Jesus have promised to take us there, to live forever in, my God, eternal peace and eternal happiness. That place where there there will be no more sorrow. There will be no more pains. My God, there will be no more heartaches and headaches and the troubles that we are seeing now. My God, I want you to understand. Hallelujah. The Bible reads it. And there shall in no wise enter into it anything that defile it, neither whatsoever work it abomination or make it a lie, but they which are written in the Lamb's book of life. You can be in the Lamb's book of life today and be in the book of remembrance tomorrow. The book of remembrance, it is a book that remember the sins that you have committed and all the sins that you never repented of.
Amen.
But a book of life, it is the book that my God that records, hallelujah, your life in Christ and the things that you're doing for Jesus. There is a book of life and a book of remembrance. But my God, what Paul is saying, it is my God, they that make it a lie, they that are in working abomination, they that defile it, my God himself. I want you to understand, he said, my God, he said that their name, hallelujah, but they with the only day, hallelujah, which name are written in the book of life, hallelujah.
Amen.
Only they who are written in the book of life is going to enter. Rosh Hashanah, it is a time to know if your name is written in the Lamb book of life, hallelujah. It is a time to know, hallelujah. No one, praise the name of the Lord, can tell you if your name is written. You ought to know if your name is written there. You see, I want you to know, hallelujah, that scripture again. But they which are written in the Lamb book of life, that scripture is proving here that all the nations of the new earth will have their names written also in the book of life and be saved, hallelujah. Yes, my God, I think it's Revelation spoke about it, and Revelation what spoke about it in Revelations 21, I think. Revelations 21, praise the name of the Lord. Revelations 21, from verses 24 to 27. The Bible reads there, and the nation of them which are saved shall walk in the light of it, and the kings of the earth do bring their glory and honor unto it, and the gates of it shall not be shut at all by day, for there shall be no night there, hallelujah, and they shall bring the glory and honor of the nations unto it, and they shall in no wise enter into it anything, as we read just now, that was defiled and things that make it alive. I want you to understand, hallelujah, my God, we ought to make sure that our name is inscribed in the Lamb's book of life, hallelujah. I'm not in remembrance. You see, the only way to have one name inscribed in the Lamb book of life, hallelujah, inscribed in it, is true faith in Jesus Christ. True faith in Jesus Christ as Savior from sin. And then, hallelujah, my God, you know, it is in St. John Gospel, chapter 10, verses 27 to 30. St. John Gospel, chapter 27 to 30. Oh, yes, Jesus said that, my sheep hear my voice. Hallelujah. Jesus said, my sheep, hallelujah, they hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. He said, and I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall any man pluck them out of my hands. He said, my Father which give them me is greater than all, and no man is able to pluck them out of my Father's hand. Hallelujah. He said, I and my Father, we are one. Hallelujah. This is somebody. There are three things that man must do and continue and continue in to receive. My God, three things man must do and continue in to receive eternal life. And one of those things, it is believe, which implies, my God, complete and continue obedience. One must believe, which implies, hallelujah, which imply, my God, which implies complete and continued obedience. If you look, my God, we read just now, hallelujah, that scripture in St. John 10 and 26. But he believed not, hallelujah, that St. John 10 and 26. But he believed not because you are not my sheep. As I said unto you, so I said to you, one of, my God, the three things that men must do to continue highly into receiving my, or to receive eternal life from God, I want you to understand, it is believing in God, which implies complete and continue obedience. Oh yes, in St. John 6 and verses 47, Jesus said, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me have everlasting life. He that believeth on me have everlasting life. The second thing, my God, for man to have, the second thing for man to have eternal life and continued eternal life in God is to hear God's voice and be not hearers only, but also be doers of his word. Hallelujah. Somebody, I'm talking. Somebody, we are in the time of Rosh Hashanah. And my God, you ought to understand, if you want to continue, my God, in eternal life, if you want to continue, my God, in the blessings of God, if you want to continue in the salvation of God, you must hear God's voice and be not a hearer only, but also a doer of the word of God. Oh, yes, hallelujah. My God, in James chapter 1, verses 22 to 27. James chapter 1, verses 22 to 27. My God, the Bible reads there, hallelujah. But be ye doers of God's word and not hearers only, deceiving your own self, hallelujah. Deceiving your own self. For if any be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he beholdeth himself and goeth his way, and straightway forgetteth what manner of man he was. Oh yes, James is saying here, but whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continueth daring, and continueth daring, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in all his deeds. If any man among you seems to be righteous and bridleth not his tongue, but deceiveth his own heart, this man's religion is vain. This man's religion is vain. Verses 27. James said that pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this, to visit the fatherless and the widow in their affliction, and to keep himself unspotted from the world, and to keep himself unspotted from the world. Hallelujah. I want you to understand, not one drop or not one tittle of sin is going to enter into the kingdom of God. I want you to understand, the Bible is abundantly clear where that is concerned. We got to make sure that we are pure before God. You got to strive, my God, for holiness. I want you to understand, my God, there is no reason, my God, there is no reason, my God, for excuses now. I want you to understand, your excuses, they are vain, because God have been speaking to you. God have been been showing you. You know what is right. You know what is wrong. I want you to understand, now it's time to repent and pick up the pieces and make sure that your salvation be sure with God. Hallelujah. Robo Satarabaye, Rebe Besete de Behe, Yakarababa Sataba, Robo Okayam the Noria, Rume Ekayam the Noah, James and also James, chapter 2, from verses 9. Somebody, my God, I'm going to close on just now. James chapter 2, from verses 9. James said there, Ro Okayam the notable Shata, Rebebe Setedebe. James said there, my God, in James chapter 2, from verses 9 to 26. But if you have respect to person, you commit sin and are convinced of the law as transgressors. For whosoever shall keep the whole law and yet offend in one point, he is guilty of all. For he that said, do not commit adultery, said also, do not kill. Now if thou commit no adultery, yet if thou kill, thou art become a transgressor of the law. So speak ye, and so do, as they that shall be judged by the law of liberty. For he shall have judgment without mercy. For he shall have judgment without mercy that hath shown no mercy, and mercy rejoiceth against judgment. And mercy rejoices without judgment. Somebody, I want you to understand, my God, God is not mocked. And now is the time for turn around. Now is the time to make a roundabout turn. Now is the time to serve Jesus. You don't know the minute nor the hour. You don't know how long you're gonna live again. You don't know, my God, how long you have in this place. I want you to know, it is only what you do for God in your body is for last. It is only what you do for God is going to last. Hallelujah. All that you do is for yourself will perish. I say all that you do for yourself will perish. And the third and last thing, it is to follow Christ. Not only at the beginning of your Christian experience, but daily and throughout your Christian life. You got to follow Christ daily and throughout your Christian life. You know, Jesus said in Luke chapter 9 and verses 23, and he said unto them, if any man will come after me, he let him deny himself and take up his cross daily. And I want you to look at that word there. In Luke chapter 9 and verses 23. Luke chapter 9 and verses 23. Come on, I want you to look at that again. Luke chapter 9 and verses 23. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Jesus said, if any man will come after me. Hallelujah. Any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily. And I want you to look at that daily and follow me. And my God, I love that word daily. Day. Daily. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Having that willingness to follow the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Daily denying yourself. Daily denying yourself. The human self desires a lot of things. But daily denying yourself. Daily taking up your cross. Not periodically or when it is convenient and profitable to you. Not periodically or when it is convenient and profitable to you. Daily you take up your cross and you follow Jesus. Daily you deny yourself. Oh, hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. We give you the praise. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we praise you. We praise you to claim eternal life. When one does not follow, it's like those Jews claiming to know God and have eternal life. And Jesus declared such was not true. Those Jews that were claiming to have eternal life, to know God and to have eternal life, but Jesus, he told them that it was not so. My God, you will see that in St. John chapter 5, verses 37 to 47. You can read that when you go home. Oh, praise the Lord. You can read that later. And also St. John chapter 8, verses 54 to 55. If you read 54 to 55 of St. John chapter 8, the Bible reads it, and Jesus answered, if I honor myself, my honor is nothing. It is my Father that honored me, of whom ye say that he is your God. Yet ye have not known him, but I know him. And if I should say, I know him not, I shall be a liar like unto you. But I know him, and I keep his saying. I not only know him, but I keep his saying. I do not only know the Father, but I keep his saying. You know that script that I gave you to read? Praise the name of the Lord. My God, it's a lot. But you know, it is Jesus who would have been speaking there. And Jesus in St. John 5, verses 37 to 47, Jesus was saying there, and the Father himself, which had sent me, had borne witness of me. Ye have neither heard his voice at any time, nor see his shape. And ye have not his word abiding in you. For whom he had sent him, he believed not. And my God, they were professing, the Jews, to know the Lord. My God, but professing something don't mean that is what it is. Amen. So Jesus said to them in verses 37, he said, search the scriptures, for in them you think ye have eternal life, and they are they which testify of me. If you want to know who you are, if you want to know where you are, or if you are in me, search the scripture, because it testifies of me. If you look at verses 40, Jesus said, and ye will not come to me that ye might have life. I receive not honor from men, but I know you that ye have not the love of God in you. And Jesus was talking to Jews here now. He was talking to Abraham's children. He said, my God, he said, I know you that you have not the love of God in you. He went on in verses 43. He said, I am come in my Father's name, and you receive me not. If another shall come in his own name, him you will receive. So Jesus was saying here, listen to me. I come in the name of my Father, and you don't want to receive me. But if another man come in his name, you'll receive him. He come boasting about himself. He come boasting about what he can do. Yeah. And I want to know, you to know, that man, my God, might be the devil himself. Yes. Somebody, are you listening to me? Amen. Now, verses 44. I don't know why I just have to go through this with you. But verses 44, the Bible reads, Jesus said here, how can you believe which receive honor one of another and seek not the honor that cometh from God? That cometh from God only. He said, do not think that I will accuse you to the Father. There is one that accuseth you, even Moses, in whom you trust. Even my God, what Jesus is saying here, my God, but you believe in him. You believe in that one. He, my God, he was the accuser of the brethren. He is the accuser of the brethren. from the beginning, but you believe in that one. Even Moses, he accused. Praise the name of the Lord. Verses 46. Hallelujah. Verses 46. We read it up to verses 47. I told you to read at home, but I want to clear that up. Praise the name of the Lord. For had he believed Moses, you will have believed me. For he wrote of me. But if you believe not his writing, how shall you believe my words? So somebody, my God, to claim. You see, they were claiming that they had eternal life. When, my God, they had not eternal life. The Jews, that was their claim. Some of them, my God, not all of them. Some of them. So Jesus, hallelujah, he had to rebuke them. He had to rebuke them in relation, my God, to what was the truth. Hallelujah. And somebody, I want you to understand, my God, now it's time to hear the voice of God. Now it's time to hear the word of God. Now it's time to turn around and serve the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Yeah. Folks, we are celebrating Rosh Hashanah. We are celebrating a time of, my God, a day of judgment. We are celebrating, hallelujah, a day, hallelujah, of trumpets. And trumpets speak, my God, about the shofar that is being, my God, sung, and there is a distinct sound. The shofar, the sound of the shofar is very distinct. I want you to understand the sound is not contrary. And somebody, when you hear the voice of the Lord, harden not your heart. Today, if you should hear the voice of God, harden not your heart. Now it's time to wake up. Now it's time to shake up. And now it's time to serve the Lord. Jesus is coming soon. He's about to burst the cloud. The Father is about to release him. Tonight, today, as we celebrate the Feast of Trumpets, as we celebrate, my God, as we celebrate Rosh Hashanah, I want you right now to get rid of all that which is not of God and begin to buy that which is of God. Tonight, you heard the word of God. Whomsoever you might be, wheresoever you might be, you heard the word of God. And yes, praise the name of the Lord. We know without any doubt that God is speaking to you. We know that God is speaking to you. Hallelujah. We know that God is speaking to you. And we know, hallelujah, that he's not speaking to you by chance, but he's speaking to you by purpose. Tonight, before we do the benediction, and tonight we want to declare certain things in your life that comes with these appointed days of God. I want you to understand that these appointed days of God are also days when God, hallelujah, come to you not empty-handed, but he comes to you to bless. Amen. This is the reason why we encourage you for these, my God, these appointed days, that you don't come empty-handed. It is good time. It is a very good time for sowing of seed. You know, my God, the Bible teaches us, my God, about sowing and reaping. It is a good time. It is a good season. It is a good day. Praise the name of the Lord. To set aside a sacrificial offering and say, God, I am going to sow the seed and I'm believing you for this. It is a good day for you, praise the name of the Lord, to believe God for things that you never believed that could have come to pass in your life. And I want you to understand, hallelujah, God is well able to turn things around for you. He's well able to open those doors that may have seemed to be shut for so many years. He's well able to bring to pass the desires of your heart. Hallelujah. As you have been designed to see things happening for so long, I want you to understand there is power in sowing. Hallelujah. I want you to know, my God, the God of promise, that my God, if you prove me, I am going to open the windows of heaven and I'm going to pour you on blessings that you yourself will not be able to contain. I'm going to cause those blessings to be pressed down, to be shaken together, and to be running over. I'm going to cause much to be poured into your bosom. Hallelujah. But before we make those declarations tonight, we want you right now, hallelujah, we want you to bow your heads and your hearts. I just want you to bow your heads and your heart. And for those of you, hallelujah, who don't know the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and maybe you know him, but my God, you are not in the place that you ought to be with him, I want you to confess your sins openly. Right, my God, where you are. I want you to know, my God, even in the condition that you are in, I want you to understand that God is willing and ready to forgive you. Only if, listen to me, God only hear the prayer of a repentant sinner. He don't listen to the prayer of sinners unless they are repentant. And I want you to understand, if my God, if your life is wrapped up and tangled up in sin, and you have not repented those sins, then my God, your sins is piled up in the book of remembrance, and you need to remove them from there and make sure that your name is written in the Lamb's book of life. And the only way for you to do so, it is for you to repent of your sins. I want you right now, right where you are, I want you to repent of your sins right now. Say these words after me. Say, Heavenly Father, in the name of your son Jesus, I come before you, asking of you to forgive me for the many sins I've committed against you in my thoughts, in my words, and in my deeds. Blot out my transgressions. Let your integrity and let your uprightness preserve me. For I put my trust in you. I put my hope in you. Let not those that trust in you, Lord, be ashamed. Father, forgive me for my sins. Teach me to know you, to love you and serve you. Father, I commit my life unto you in the name of your son Jesus. In the name of your son Jesus. And everybody shout. And everybody shout. And everybody shout. Amen. Father, we lift up your people. We lift them up right now. And I want you right where you are with your love offerings and your seed offering, whatsoever part of the world that you might be. And you have an offering today, even, hallelujah, as a seed offering, believing that God is going to cause that seed to burst forth and bring forth much fruit to you. I want you to hold that right now. And I want you to hold it as you believe God, as we trust God. And we're going to make some declarations here. And we want you to be agreeing, hallelujah, with us as we make this declaration. Hallelujah. Father, it's not by might, neither is by power. It is by your spirit. It is by the anointing. The anointing breaks every yoke. Your name be glorified. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, we just want you to make that declaration. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He shall give his angels charge concerning you. And in their hands they shall bear us up, lest at any time we dash our feet against a stone. May the Lord comfort us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort wherein we ourselves are comforted of the Lord. May we inherit the blessings of the earth. May His mercy be with us from generation to generation. Hallelujah. Let those which be of faith be blessed with faithful Abraham. May the Lord give to us the former rain moderately. May He cause to come down for us the rain, the former rain and the latter rain in the first month. May our floors be filled of wheat, and the vats shall overflow with wine and with oil. May He restore to us the years that the locusts have eaten, the canker worm and the caterpillar and the palm worm, by His great army which He has sent among us. May He eat in plenty. May you eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God that had dwelt wondrously with you. You shall never be ashamed. You shall never be ashamed. You shall always know that the Lord your God is in the midst of you, and that He is the Lord your God and none else, and His people shall never be ashamed. God, people, you shall never be ashamed. May the Lord blessings bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make His face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. Father God, Father, it's not by might, it is not by power, it is by your spirit. Oh yes, hallelujah. The Lord blessings, the Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make His face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up His countenance upon thee and give you peace in the name of Jesus. May the name of Jesus and all its blessings be upon you. May the name of Jesus and all its blessings be upon you. May the name of Jesus and all its blessings be upon you. Father, we declare your blessings. We declare your anointing. We declare your power. We declare the victory. No weapon that is formed against your people, none shall prosper. All that is risen up against them, we condemn them right now. We take back all that which the enemy has stolen, and we return it unto them right now. No weapon that will ever be formed against them, man shall prosper. And all that is risen up, we condemn it right now. Father, 1,000 will fall at their side, and 10,000 at the right hand, but it shall not come near thee. They shall not come near them. Father God, we destroy plagues. We destroy Almighty God poverty. We come up against, oh God, a destruction. We come up against sudden death. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we break stronghold. We take back, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We take back in the name of Jesus. We take back in the name of Jesus. We declare the power of your kingdom. Robo soto robo, yeah.
Robo Soto Roboya. Robo Soto Roboya. Rebebe Satarabaya. Yonder Robo Yeke. Robo Sata. Yekete. Yekata. Yokota. Room in the candle. Spirit of the living God. Powers of the living God. Powers of the living God. Powers of the living God. Yes, Lord. 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 Father, we thank you for the victory. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Lord, you're great. Lord, you're great. You're great. You're great. You're great. You're so great. You're great. Roma Ekandanodia. Robo Okayandanai. Robo Bosatarabaye. Robo Bosatarabaya. Robo Bosatarabaye. Robo Bosatarabaya. Robo Bosetarebeye. Robo Bosatarabaya. Robo Bosite. Robo Bosataba. Rebebe setebe yokotoro yakatara robo site yatarai yende norobo saya yeketere robo ye yande noy yande noy yande noy. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Father, we give you praise, we give you the praise, we give you the honor, we give you the glory. Yeah, Lord, yeah, Lord, yeah, Lord. Yeah, Lord. Father, we praise your name. We lift up your name. We glorify your name. We exalt your name. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord now. Praise the Lord, my God. Yes. You will see the words coming up on the screen. And I want you to just sing this song. I want you to just sing this song. Praise the name of the Lord as the words come up the screen. You can sing it in your own. Hallelujah. As the words come up on your screen. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Father, we give you the praise. We give you the praise. We give you the honor. We give you the honor. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you.
Yata yanda norabo sitebe. Oh, Spirit of the living God. Powers of the living God. Father, it is not by my, it is not by power. It is by your Spirit. It is by the knowing. Your goodness is running after us. Your goodness is running after us. Your goodness is running after us. Hallelujah. 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 We praise you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. Your name be glorified. Your name be glorified. Your name be lifted up. Your name be exalted. Your name be exalted. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we give you the praise. We give you the praise. We give you the honor. We give you the glory. Father, we thank you tonight. We thank you tonight. We thank you tonight. Father, bless them, Lord. Bless them, Lord. Bless them, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. There is a sweet anointing. And we know that this anointing is the presence of the Lord. I want you to know, that this anointing, there will be an overflow and an overflow. Because somebody, it is a season that runs on, and there will continue to be overflow in the spirit. And I want you to know, it is a time of blessing. It is a time to open up yourself and be blessed and just allow. Yes, in the notable. Yes, I am. You more lost. Yes, no, yes, Father, we give you the praise. 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 Father, we bless your name. We bless your name. We bless your name tonight. Praise the Lord. If you follow this anointing, we can go for the rest of the night. If you follow this anointing, we can go for the rest of the night. Oh yes, there is a sweet anointing in this place. I know it's the presence of the Lord. 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 Yes, I know. It is the presence of the Lord. I say, I know, I know, I know, I know that I know that I know. I know that it's the presence of the Lord. I know that he's here to bless. I know that he's here to deliver. I know that he's here to set free. I know that he's here to open doors. I know that he's here to do it for your man, to do it for your woman. Yes, the 10 things are wrong. He's here to give you strength. He's here to give you the victory. Oh yes, he's here for those who believe. 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 Spirit of the living God, Father, we give you the praise. 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 We give you the praise tonight. 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 Robo yeke. Robo boyaka. Robo boyokoro. Ikete roboko. Yakatara. Rebe Ebe Shetebe Yatakaya Yananoria. Tonight, tonight, tonight is your night. Tonight is your night, man, woman. Tonight is your night. This is your hour. Your hour. Open up your spirit. Open up your heart. And let him be according to that which he wants to be. He can be anything that you want him to be. Rule you. Rule your candidate. Spirit of the living God. 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 Powers of the living God. Powers of the living God. Powers of the living God. Father, we give it the praise. We give it the praise. We give it the honor. We give it the glory. We bless your holy name. We bless your holy name. Tonight, hallelujah. Tonight, praise the Lord. Tonight there is a sweet anointing. And we just want you to continue in that anointing. We cannot close this meeting in prayer because we just want you to continue in this anointing. Ruokai and the Noria. We will be back on. Ruokai and the Noria. We will be back on Thursday night. And we're expecting that anointing to continue to flow. We invite you, whomsoever you be, wheresoever you are, feel free and join us. Hallelujah. In the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy. And in his right hand, pledge of forevermore. Brethren, hallelujah. God blessings be upon each of you tonight. And I pray, hallelujah. Ruokai am denied that victory, his victory that is given to us, the victory that has been given to us, will continue to overtake us. Hallelujah. Can you lift your hands like this right now? Can you just lift your hands like this? I just want to close off tonight. I just want to close off. Robo setere yekere, robo bosokora reketere, robo bosataba yetekere. May the grace of our God and the sweet fellowship of his Holy Spirit continue to rest, remain, and abide with us both now and forever. And everybody shout, amen, amen, amen. God bless you.